Hi folks, today I bring you another DVD player panel. It uses a 7 segments LED display with some predefined symbols. The driver is one SM1623B, and once again we are faced with the swapping of digits by segments in order to overcome the need for 10 digits when the driver only allows 7 digits or grids. The wires connections will stay at the end of the video and the code link stay on the description. The DVD player brand is Advanced Plus model DHD score 1088. Of course, we can find the panel in the other brand's variants. Considering the contents that is already present on the channel, there is not much to highlight other than the swapping of the grids by segments and the order of the connection between the display LED and the driver itself. This is already also mentioned many times in the identical panels to this one. The code is reused and has a reader for the 3 keys present on the panel, but does not assign the functions to it. I leave this task to you in order to make it possible to adjust the clock. The red LED present on the panel is permanently connected to the plus 5 volts DC through one resistor marked as a 220 on the PCB and have the value of 1 kilo ohms. Of course, you can lift the resistor and control the LED with one external pin using a transistor as a driver. The infrared receiver is available at the panel output if it is necessary to use it. I need to apply a cover on the LED because this is not the original LED and the bright is so strong, don't allow the capture of the video, okay? The connection we have done to bring the panel to life again is the same of always. We need the plus 5 volts to power up our driver and our display. It's important the G and D reference between the Arduino and our power source. This is very, very important, okay? If you don't apply this reference between the both systems, you don't see the communication happen, okay? After we have the data in, clock and the chip select. As always, I try use the same colors, okay? Orange to data, green to the clock, yellow to chip selector. I apply here 3 resistors between the pins of the communication data between the Arduino and our driver, but these resistors is not necessary. I apply it only to avoid any problems between the wrong connections happen during the test process, okay?